Well, the positive one obviously is that they want Africa's minerals, and I was quite amused when this started, because the big mining companies I felt they were treating Africa like it was a pudding that was too hot to eat. Never mind, we'll leave it till later. No one else is going to come and eat it. So even it's a bit hot at the moment, wait till it cools down, then we'll pick it up. And suddenly the Chinese had come in and were going places where they had feared to tread, and they had to move fast. It was very funny to watch these guys who'd closed, mothballed a mine here or turned down, suddenly rushing back in because the Chinese were there. So that, I think, was great. And that's very positive. The negative side is that the Chinese companies have no interest at all in democracy, in human rights. You are the government, I deal with you, and we don't ask any more questions. And it's very bad for governance in Africa, that. It can really undermine it really undermines democracy. I think what will happen there is that the Chinese will find, like everyone else, that when you move into Africa, it's wonderful to start with, and it's very welcoming and it looks easy. And gradually Africa pushes back. So they're going to have to know what's going on under the surface and adapt. And they're going to have to get involved in the politics, like them or not. So I think that's the downside of China and Africa. And the other one, of course, is it's at home. Its standards of environmental sort of social action are very low. And if they don't do it at home, why should they do it in Africa? So I think there's going to be that will also create a lot of problems as well. And the biggest cultural one to me is this is the sort of Chinese work ethic. And the problems in Zambia the year before last were, you know, the Zambians were just not used to people working all night and things like that. I mean, just absolutely. And that's why the Chinese like to bring their own workers in. And I think that will also create problems where you've got huge areas of unemployment, a road being built, and the Chinese say, no, we'll only employ our own people. I think that's going to be problematic as well. But I'm quite optimistic about this, because I think that the Chinese are desperately concerned about their own image. And if there are problems where they're working, I think they will respond to them, hopefully in a deep positive way, not just trying to paper it over. But I think they will realize that their reputation means a lot to them. And if they're seen to be replicating what the colonialists did, they will change course and do things differently.